Now we have verse 16. Then the king commanded, they brought Daniel and cast him into the den of lions. Now the king spoke and said unto Daniel, thy God, whom thou servest continually, he will deliver thee. And I'm of the opinion the king didn't believe that. I think that that was one of these half-hearted things that some of us saints say today. We say to somebody else, oh, the Lord will take care of you. And when you and I get in that predicament, we don't quite trust him like that. Now, this king, though, has come a long ways. He recognizes that the God of Daniel was omnipotent and sovereign. He could deliver him. And he also saw that Daniel was faithful to God. Daniel's testimony in the dissolute court of two world powers is nothing short of miraculous. And his unaffected and unassuming life was a powerful witness to the saving grace of God in that day. Well, they put a stone against the mouth of the lion's den, and Daniel spent the night down there. Now, these lions were fierce and wild beasts. They were not toothless lions. I remember years ago that there was a man that got a job in a zoo, and they wanted him to go in the lion's cage to feed the lions. And he said, no. And the keeper says, look, said, those lions are toothless. And he said, yes, says, I noticed that, but he said, they could gum me to death. Well, these lions had teeth, and they were fierce lions, but the safest place that night just happened to be the lion's den. And I think Daniel got a pretty good night's sleep down there. And the interesting thing is, it was the king that was in danger more than Daniel. Now, will you notice verse 18? Then the king went to his palace, passed the night fasting. He didn't sleep. Daniel did. Neither were instruments of music brought before him, and his sleep went from him. He passed a sleepless night due to his concern for Daniel. Then in verses 19 and 20, then the king arose very early in the morning and went in haste unto the den of lions. When he came to the den, he cried with a lamentable voice unto Daniel. And the king spoke and said to Daniel, O Daniel, servant of the living God, is thy God whom thou servest continually able to deliver thee from the lions? Well, I don't know whether the king expected Daniel to answer, but Daniel answered. And Daniel said to the king, O king, live forever. And he said, did you have a good night? And of course, the king didn't have a good night. Daniel had a good night. And now verse 23, then was the king exceedingly glad for him, commanded they should take Daniel up out of the den. So Daniel was taken up out of the den, and no manner of hurt was found upon him, because he believed in his God. Now we find Daniel lifted to a very high position. And we're told, the last verse, so this Daniel prospered in the reign of Darius and in the reign of Cyrus the Persian. And that is the man also that Daniel led to a knowledge of the living God. This man Daniel is one of the great men of Scripture. Now next time we go to the prophetic section. So until then, may God richly bless you, my beloved.